Are you struggling with your child having diaper rash? In this video, you're going to learn how to treat it and how to avoid it in the future. There are basically two kinds of diaper rash. There is the regular bacterial irritation to the skin, and then there's a yeast infection. I know you've been probably struggling with this rash with your child, so first let's go over what to do if they already have a rash, and then what to do if you go through all of these steps and the rash continues to get worse. Number one, keep the skin dry and clean as much as possible. Regardless of the cause of the rash, this is the number one basic to treat and to avoid diaper rashes. Number two, use fragrance-free wipes. If you're changing a poopy diaper, you will need to clean up initially with either a wet cloth or a paper towel or fragrance-free baby wipes. Fragrances will cause more skin irritation, so be sure not to use anything that has been washed with scented soaps or detergents or contains anything like that. Number three, use a spray bottle with warm water. Once you get the fecal matter basically cleaned away, it's best to use a spray bottle for the rest of the cleaning rather than baby wipes. If they just have a wet diaper, a spray bottle will do. You don't even need to use baby wipes at all. The reason it's a good idea to use a spray bottle with maybe a little bit of warm water in it is because that rash is going to be painful. The child is probably going to be fussing and crying, and that's a legitimate thing at that point because they are in pain. So it's better to use a spray bottle and pat as much as possible rather than wipe. Sometimes you might have to wipe here and there, but try to use a spray bottle that's going to soothe them. It's going to soothe the skin down a little bit and make it easier to clean them up. Number four, use disposable diapers while they have a rash. I know some people are sold on cloth, but disposable diapers draw the moisture away from the skin, and this is a huge advantage when dealing with diaper rashes. Number five, allow skin to air dry if possible. If you're able, depending on the situation, go ahead and let the child's bottom just air dry. You can even use a fan or whatever, even up to a half an hour before re-diapering, because you want that air to get onto the skin. That helps it heal faster. Number six, apply a thick diaper cream. The next step is to create a barrier between their skin and irritants. A regular over-the-counter cream like Desitin or Balmex works fine. Apply a thick layer to be sure no irritants will penetrate it. Number seven, apply cornstarch powder. Putting straight cornstarch from your kitchen or cornstarch-based baby powder on top of the cream will keep the diaper from getting all sticky, and it's also good for the skin. Don't use talcum-based powder. They have been shown to cause respiratory illnesses. Companies that were selling talcum-based powders have been recalling them because of this concern. Number eight, change the diaper often. Check their diaper at least every half hour and change it immediately when you see they have gone in it. Now, if you've been doing all eight of these steps and the rash is not healing, it might even be getting worse, it could be that this is a yeast-based skin infection. Yeast-based infections generally happen when the mom has a yeast-based infection herself, or she or her baby have been taking antibiotics to correct an illness or help with an illness. So a lot of times, if your baby is going to take antibiotics, and you already know that because they've been prescribed some, go ahead and start putting that thick diaper cream on before the rash starts. Go ahead and start putting that cornstarch-based powder on them before they start taking the antibiotics, if you're able to do that, because that will avoid the rash from the beginning. Do the same thing if you're breastfeeding and you know you're going to be taking antibiotics for some reason. Go ahead and start to prevent that from happening in the first place. But if your child does get a yeast-based rash infection, you want to get some over-the-counter medications that are antifungal. So you do all the same things, except before you put the cream on, you go ahead and put this antifungal cream on instead. And then you can add the other things that we've talked about. This will help get rid of that yeast infection. So if the rash starts to boil, if it's bleeding, or if it spreads outside the diaper area, it's time to go see a doctor, especially if that is also accompanied by a fever that's over 100.4. You'll need to take them to the doctor immediately. That is not just a normal diaper rash. So if this video has been helpful for you, please hit that like button and subscribe and check out one of the cards that you're seeing on the screen right now. Parents, you can do this. Thanks for watching.